Everybody listen up, gather around. We're here today because UVM has once again failed their students, failed their Palestinian students, and attempted to censor Palestinian voices. UVM has canceled unilaterally the guest lecture of Mohammed El-Khoury against the wishes of both sponsoring departments, College of Arts and Sciences, against the wishes of the student body. Time when we need to be uplifting Palestinian voices, listening to their perspectives, uplifting them, and standing with them. We have a letter today to deliver to Suresh Garamella and to the University of Administration to tell them that we say no to censorship, that we stand with Mohammed El-Khoury. We're going to be out here with a few speakers. We're going to be doing some chants, and we are going to take our letter, walk inside, and deliver it to Suresh Garamella to show that the student body stands with free speech, with Palestine, and with Mohammed El-Khoury. Suresh, you can't hide. Suresh, you can't hide. Suresh, you can't hide.
Suresh, you can't hide.
You can't censor Palestine.
You can't censor Palestine.
Suresh, you can't hide.
Suresh, you can't hide.
You can't censor Palestine.
You can't censor Palestine.
Let him speak.
Let him speak. Let him speak. Let him speak.
Let him speak.
Let him speak.
Let him speak.
Let him speak.
Let him speak.
It is unconscionable that the UVM administration should be allowed to do this without hearing from the entire student body, from every single student who rejects censorship, that we do not approve this. We reject this, and we will not tolerate it. We will not stand idly by while UVM once again contributes to a racist environment that Palestinian students do not feel comfortable in, that they feel repressed in.
When I say UVM silence, you say violence. UVM silence!
Violence!
UVM silence!
Violence!
UVM silence!
Violence!
UVM silence!
Violence! Let him speak!
Let him speak! Let him speak! Let him speak! Let him speak! Let him speak! Let him speak. Let him speak. Let him speak. Let him speak. Let him speak.
I'm going to read before you the letter that four different student organizations have drafted to tell Suresh that we reject this, that we condemn this, that we find it disgusting, that we are appalled that the UVM administration would do this.
Outside the
Waterman
building in UVM right now, where you can
see
people are gathering.
Let him speak. 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 Let him speak.
Citing safety concerns.
Dear President Suresh Garamella, we, the undersigned organizations, are appalled by your administration's decision to cancel the planned guest lecture of Palestinian writer and poet Mohammed El-Khoury. This cancellation is a betrayal of every single point of UVM's common ground. We are writing to condemn your administration's censorship of Palestinian voices and utter disregard for your Palestinian students.
Again, right now you can see
El-Khoury was scheduled to come to campus at a critical moment when Israel is unleashing a genocidal military campaign against the Palestinian people. Thousands of Palestinians have been killed, neighborhoods have been flattened, hospitals have been bombed, and the IDF has cut off food, water, and electricity. To silence a renowned figure like Mohammed El-Khoury at a time when we collectively have an imperative to uplift the voices of Palestinians is disgraceful. Following your initial letter, 2 weeks ago, to the student body, which did not even mention the word Palestine or Palestinians.
Shame!
Shame!
UVM's cancellation of this event has reverberated across the entire student body. Palestinian students have long reported that Palestinian speech and expression on campus has been met with increasing racism and hostility. Your administration's attempt to silence a man who many regard as the most influential Palestinian voice has sent a clear message that your administration is not only complicit in UVM's anti-Palestinian environment, but an active participant in it. Shame!
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 Your administration's stated reasoning behind the cancellation, concerns that the event posed a threat to other students, stokes a racist paranoia towards Palestinian students at a time when we are seeing anti-Palestinian hate crimes, repression, surveillance, and bigotry. We demand that you take every step possible to rectify your administration's decision. We demand that you apologize to your Palestinian students, to all students on campus who value free speech, most of all, to Mohammed Al-Khour. We demand that you recognize the brutal genocide that Palestinians are facing and rectify your administration's carelessness towards their struggles on campus and globally. We demand that you respect the right of Palestinian students to free expression and all necessary steps to combat the racism on campus that they have experienced. Suresh, Suresh, you can hide!
Suresh, Suresh, you can hide!
You won't censor Palestine!
You won't censor Palestine!
Suresh, Suresh, you can hide!
Suresh, Suresh, you can hide!
You won't censor Palestine!
You won't censor Palestine!
We assembled this protest with less than 10 hours of notice, and still, we have all of you here today representing the thousands of people that have sent emails, who have shared our posts. Next time. Thousands of people speaking out right now to say, UVM, shame on you!
Shame.
UVM! Shame on you!
UVM, shame on you!
UVM, shame on you!
UVM, shame on you!
It has been made clear in the last few days that the campus stands with Palestine and with free speech. UVM's cancellation of this event goes against the wishes of the entire student body. It demonstrates the anti-Palestinian racism that is crawled its way into the upper levels of the administration. But we are here united as a student body, as the university community, to say, no, we do not, we will not consent to this. We will shut it down. We will not stand for censorship. We will stand with Palestine. Suresh, Suresh, shame on you.
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 Suresh, Suresh, you can't hide.
Suresh, Suresh, you can't hide.
You won't censor Palestine.
You won't censor Palestine.
When I say every time the media lies, you say a neighborhood in Gaza dies.
Every time the media lies,
a neighborhood in Gaza dies.
Every time the media lies,
a neighborhood in Gaza dies.
Every time the media lies,
a neighborhood in Gaza dies.
Every time the media lies,
a neighborhood in Gaza dies.
Every time the media lies,
a neighborhood in Gaza dies.
Free, free Palestine.
Free, free Palestine.
Long live Palestine.
Long live Palestine.
Academic institution like UVM take a stand against justice. It is heartbreaking that the censorship will take place here in Vermont, in the United States, in behalf of what? They said fear and security. Fear and security that they are implanting here in UVM against Arabs, against Muslims, against Palestinian students, and all the solidarity groups stands behind them. Are we going to accept that?
No!
Are we going to tolerate that?
No!
Are you with the freedom of speech?
Yes!
Are you with the First Amendment?
Yes!
Now, I wanna give a message to my dear, dear Jewish siblings of this institution. We agree with you that anti-Semitism existed and we should fight that. You cannot fight it by yourself. The only place you can fight anti-Semitism that you come to our side. Racism, anti-Semitism, Islamophobia, anti-LGBTQA plus existed and existed on this institution. But we should say it clear. The Jewish faith is not Zionism.
That's right.
The Jewish faith is not Zionism. And we never claimed that a Jewish group will censor us. And the president of Hillel House on this institution claimed. But Zionist group on this institution censoring us.
Right.
And we differentiate between the great faith of Judaism. Our siblings, you have to come to our side. Have to come our side. If you want to fight justice, please stand with us. Stand with the black students. Stand with the indigenous people. Stand with the migrants. Stand with the immigrants. But don't say we are anti-Semitism as they claim. He's a coward. Because he ordered this institution to cancel Muhammad, but we are all Muhammad today. We are all speaking his language, and we stand with Free Palestine.
Free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Long live Palestine!
Long live Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Long live Palestine!
Long live Palestine!
It's ironic that for an administration that refuses to even acknowledge the existence of Palestine or its Palestinian students in need of support, that they were so quick come out and censor one of the foremost voices speaking on their behalf.
Shame!
Shame!
It's one thing to so obviously take the side of genocide, the side of racism, and the side of hate. It's another to silence those willing to come into your house, spit in the face of your cowardice, your greed, and your hatred of the people who walk your campus, attend your classes, and pay your salary. We will not let them silence Mohammed El Kurd. We will not let them silence Palestinian voices. We will not let them silence us. If we stand idle now and let them set this precedent, UVM will attempt to censor all speech that challenges the status quo. Their status quo! We will not let them! UVM, we will speak up against any and all future attempts to censor those who see injustice on and off campus and choose to speak up. As a united front, we will not back down. We will fight back. This is not the end. This does not end with Mohammed El-Kurd. I know we will all make sure of that. Solidarity forever.
I say UVM silence. You say violence. UVM silence.
Violence.
UVM silence.
Violence.
UVM silence.
Violence.
UVM silence.
Violence.
When Palestine is under attack, what do we do?
Stand up for death!
Palestine is under attack, what do we do?
Stand up for death!
Journalists are under attack, what do we do?
Stand up for death!
Journalists are under attack, what do we do?
Stand up for death!
Free speech is under attack, what do we do?
Stand up for death!
Free speech is under attack, what do we do?
Stand up for death!
Palestine is under attack, what do we do?
Stand up for death!
Palestine is under attack, what do we do?
Stand up for death!
Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Long live Palestine!
Long live Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Before we go inside and before we deliver our letter of demands to Suresh Garamella and to the UVM administration, anyone is welcome to come up and speak, to talk about how outrageous this decision is, to talk about how this is affecting the entire student body, how this sets a precedent for censorship, not just for Palestine, but for any subversive speech. Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Long live Palestine!
Long live Palestine!
Let him speak!
Let him speak! Let him speak! Let him speak! Let him speak! Let him speak! Let him speak! Let him speak! Let him speak! Let him speak! Let him speak! Let him speak! Let him speak! Let him speak! Let him speak! Let him speak! Let him speak!
Every time the media lies,
neighborhood in Gaza dies.
Every time the media lies,
neighborhood in Gaza dies.
Every time the media lies,
neighborhood in Gaza dies.
We're going to be orderly, we are going to be peaceful, but we are going to be powerful, we are going to be united, and we are going to say with a clear voice, no to censorship, yes to free speech. We stand with Mohammed El-Kurd.
Free, free Palestine! Free, free Palestine! Long live Palestine! Long live Palestine! Long live Palestine! Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Long live Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
decision, we will tell UVM that this does not stand. Shame!
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 I am saddened to announce that the board of the Will Miller Lecture Series has announced that the event will have to be held online now. It is once again shameful that UVM has denied this opportunity to Palestinian students and all of their students to meet this incredible man, this incredible voice of Palestine. But we will not let him be unheard. Everyone, attend his virtual panel, listen to what he has to say, share the word around, and make it clear that UVM's attempts to silence this man are futile. They are futile.
Woo.
Let him speak!
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 I just want to clarify, the event's going to be held by Haymarket Books. It's not school sponsored anymore, obviously, but if you're looking for information on where to actually access the event, check out the Haymarket Books.
And one thing, as thousands are emailing the UVM administration, telling them, shame on you for canceling this event, some of them have been getting replies saying, oh, well, the event's online happening, it's not canceled anyway. They're trying to take credit for the lecture series board's decision to hold this event in spite of their attempts to cancel it. Shame!
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 Shame! I just want to make a quick announcement. There's an action being put on by folks in Vermont connected with Jewish Voices for Peace, and it's Jews Against Genocide, and we're calling on our congressional representatives in Vermont to sign on to the ceasefire resolution. And so that's Thursday at 4:30 on Church Street in front of City Hall Park. Appreciate you all organizing around this and hope to see some of you there.
Thank you, everyone. Please get home safe.